In this first lesson, you will learn how to set up your Go environment and write your first application. Welcome to the first lesson. Are you ready to start programming in Go language? So, let's start. First of all, let's talk about Go language. It's been created by Google. It became open source in November 2009. Why is it so successful that a lot of programmers are moving to Go? Because it is minimalistic, very easy to learn. The code is very readable and it makes it very easy to learn and also to maintain the code made by other developers. It's aimed to multi-threading, so it can use at best the new CPU with many cores that can run many threads at the same time. Offer good performances, so it's a very powerful tool. And we are just about to learn this tool. In a few lessons, you will be able to create even complex application. But let's do it one step at a time. So the first step will be set up the environment for our platform, PC, Mac, or Linux, and then write our first application. So first of all, let's set up the environment. To do it, we go to the golang.org website. This is the homepage of Go, programming language. Here you can find a button called Download Go. Let's press it. It brings to the download page. Here you can find the setup environment for all the major platforms, so Microsoft Windows, Apple macOS, Linux, and also the source file if you want to compile it in a platform different than macOS, Linux, or Windows. For instance, if you use BSD. In our case, we will use Microsoft Windows, but everything in this course can be done in Linux or macOS, so you are free to use your computer with your platform. Just because most of you have Windows, I will use Windows to show our lessons, but don't make any difference. So let's click Microsoft Windows and install the environment. As you can see, an installer is downloaded, and just download it, run it, is a normal Windows installer, and you will have your Go environment set up. I suggest also to download Visual Studio Code. You can have it, download it from codevisualstudio.com/download. Don't worry, the URL will all be in the description of this video. Visual Studio Code is a Microsoft product. It's totally free. You don't have to subscribe to anything. You just need to select the platform. It can be Windows or Linux. You have an option of either Debian or RPM, depending if you are using a Debian distribution like Ubuntu or an RPM distribution like Red Hat, Fedora, SUSE, CentOS, or you have the installer for the Mac. Just click the platform you have, and the installer will be downloaded and you can install it. I already installed my machine, so I just show you how to download, then you know how to install a program on your computer. The first lesson will not use Visual Studio Code for now. We will use at the end of the lesson. Visual Studio Code will make a lot easier all things, because you can have one environment where you are the code, you can enter your code, and you can test without leaving that environment. But the first application will be very easy, so let's do it in the command prompt. In Linux, macOS, or Windows, anyway, let's just create a directory and let's write our source code in that directory using our preferred test editor. It can be VI, Notepad, or whatever. I created a directory called source. At the moment it's empty. Let's fill it with our first program. I want to create a program that is called My First Application. So, using my favorite editor, I create a file called myfirstapplication.go. I'm on Windows, so I can create it using Notepad. Notepad myfirstapplication.go. So, now we have a blank window with no code inside. We have to write the code for our program. So, let's start writing it. First of all, we need to declare the package that contains our application. We can call it package main. The package main will be the main part of code, so the code to run when the application is started. It will contain a function called main that is the first function to call, so the first group of lines instructions to call when the program runs. So my package main will need to import some libraries, so some packages. Main is a package, but it will rely on some other packages. Packages are a set of instructions that are made by Google or by the contributors in order to make you able to do even complex applications with just few lines. You just call the package, you say to the package what you want. In this case, we need a package that gives us a command to write on the screen. This package is called FMT. So let's import FMT package. So we tell our program we use FMT. The compiler will load FMT when it compiles the program and make it executable. And then let's start writing our program. Will be something like func, that means function, main, because it's the main function of the program. These need to be called main because the program starts always with a function called main, like C language, if you know C language. Then we open a bracket. Please note that the bracket should be always near the function name, cannot be in a new line like in C language. Just go to a new line, tab, and we say to the program, write on the screen hello world. This is done using FMT, as I said before, dot the method of FMT, so the command, print, and then print line. This command accepts a parameter. A parameter is something you pass to the command to have the elaboration done. In this case, the parameter is the text, hello world. So let's write hello world. Please note that hello world is a constant text. As you can see, it is enclosed in quotation marks. This is called a string. A string is a text enclosed in quotation mark. It is the way you represent a text in most programming languages, including Go. As you can see also, all the methods, the commands, have receive a parameter that is enclosed in brackets this way. So remember, when you call a command, you have to use the bracket. Difference of the other languages like C, there is no comma or something, a semicolon to put at the end of the line, just you write the line. But you need to close your function, so you need to put a bracket at the end of the function, a curly bracket to close your function. My program is just finished. Very easy, very handy. Let's recap. We declare the package main, that will be our program. The program imports the package FMT, that is a library that gives us the method to write on the screen. And then our program, the core of our program, is the function main, that is just call the println method of MT package, and it passes to it the parameter hello world, so the string to display on the screen. Let's save it and let's run it to see if it works. I save. We saved our program. We can see it just in the directory, myfirstapplication.go. Now we want to run it to see if it works. To do this, we just write go run and then the name of the Go program. As you can see, hello world appears on the screen, so the program works. Usually you won't have your program running without the go run command. You just want to create an executable. You can do this just writing go build and then the name of the program. This is called compiling the program, and the result is an .exe called myfirstapplication.exe. So the same name of the source, just .exe. Of course, if I write myfirstapplication.exe, I have my program running without using the Go command. So you can give your program to a friend or a client or to everybody that doesn't have the Go environment installed. So we wrote our first application. Now let's see how Visual Studio Code can make easier to manage our application, to write and to test our application. Let's start Visual Studio Code. When Visual Studio Code starts, let's go to the menu View, Extensions, and let's search the extension called Go. I already installed it. Anyway, let's click it. You will see install instead of uninstall here. Just click install, install this extension. This gives you the support for Go language in Visual Studio Code. Once you have installed the extension, you can load your file, or you can write a new one. In this case, we'll load our file. And you see, the keywords are highlighted in blue, the string are red, so we have syntax highlighting, and this already makes easy to recognize mistakes. Also, we can go there and run our program. I press run, and in the console my program will appear soon. As you can see, my program run, you see the message hello world, and the process exit with the code 0. The exit code is the code that the program returns to operating system. 0 means no error, a different number means an error code. So we are able to run our program inside Visual Studio Code without having to go to the command prompt, say go run, and run the program and then go back to the editor. In this lesson, we learned how to write our first application, how to set up the Go environment on our computer, and how to use Visual Studio Code to make programming in Go more handy. This is the first step in our journey to learn the programming on Go. So, I hope you like this lesson. If so, please click like and subscribe to the channel. Every week there will be a new lesson, and in few lessons we will be able to make even more complex application. So stay with us, start coding now.